If you've ever resized something in Procreate and ended up with blurry lines, don't worry, you're not alone.
I get this question all the time, and today I'm going to show you exactly how to resize things the right way without losing quality. First, why does this happen? The answer is it's all about pixels. So Procreate is a pixel-based app, which means that when you resize something, the app kind of has to guess how to fill in or remove pixels. That's why it can make things look very soft, a little bit fuzzy, or kind of just off. Because here's what's happening. Imagine your artwork is made up of tiny little squares. When you resize something in Procreate, the app needs to either add new pixels if you make it bigger, or remove some existing pixels to make it smaller in order to match the new size. And this process isn't always perfect, and that's why you might end up with a blurry artwork. But let me show you exactly how to prevent this from happening. So my number one tip to avoid having things looking pixelated in Procreate is to obviously start with a big canvas. This is super important. You want to start with the largest canvas possible for what you're creating. And the more pixels you start with, the more details you will have to work with. I recommend working with something like 3000 by 3000 pixels. In this particular example that I'm going to be using today, I have the exact measurements of the final cover, but if you can, try and make it bigger if your iPad can handle it. So when you create your new canvas, you also want to make sure that you are working at 300 dpi. So when you set up your dimension, for example, 3000 by 3000 pixels, always make sure you work at 300 dpi as well. Now, tip number two is to use the right interpolation setting. Tip number two is a game changer, because if you change your interpolation settings when you move, rotate, or resize something in Procreate, it uses a thing called interpolation to decide how to redraw your pixels. So like I was saying earlier, when you move or resize something in Procreate, it needs to either add pixels or remove existing ones, and it needs to follow a certain process for that. And interpolation is how Procreate determines how many pixels it needs to give the image to make a new size or a new shape. So let me show you how to change that. So this is my book cover, and this is where I have my spine and my back cover. So I'm just going to hide those for now. Let's use this ribbon as an example. So I have this ribbon on one single layer. So I had multiple layers for shadows and highlights, and I just merged everything into one single layer. I'm just going to slide on that layer and duplicate it. Now, if I am moving it just like that, it is fine. It's not going to change or anything, but that's if I start to rotate it, make it smaller, make it bigger, it's going to probably get distorted. So let me show you how to change the interpolation. You're going to select your layer with the arrow tool, and you are going to make sure you're on uniform. So it's not going to change the size, and it's going to remain proportional, whatever you do. And here you're going to tap on this little icon here with the little circle and the little squares on it. And that's where you can change the interpolation settings. So the default settings is probably going to be nearest neighbor on your iPad, and it's the simplest, the fastest type of interpolation, but it only considers one pixel on each side of the edge when calculating. And this can sometimes result in a very blurry and jagged edges, which is not what you want, but it's generally just a good option if you want something quick and simple for like a single transformation. But this wouldn't be my go-to interpolation setting. Now, bilinear is a little bit more precise, and because it considers a 2x2 area of pixels surrounding the edge, it will create the average of all four. You don't need to understand that, but it usually gives you like a smoother result than nearest neighbor. And then you've got bicubic, which considers an area of 16 pixels surrounding the edges. And because of this, it offers the smoothest and most accurate results. So in most cases, I would recommend making sure you are using bilinear, because it is fine and it will work, but don't be afraid to test all three modes and see what works best for your specific project. So sometimes one setting will give you better results depending on your art style or how you're transforming your object. So let's just test all three just so we can see the difference. So I'm just going to duplicate the artwork three times and I'm going to rename them. So I've got my three layers here, which I have renamed, and let's just resize the first one, the second one, let's make it roughly the same size so we can see, and then the third one. Now, when you make it smaller, it's going to be very hard to see if it's pixelated, so you'll have to zoom in to see the difference. In those three cases, I think this one is probably the worst. So the nearest neighbor you can see is creating some very pixelated edges. This one is a little bit better, and this one is extremely similar. So I would say these two are probably the best options. Obviously, when you zoom in, it will be pixelated. It is a pixel-based app at the end of the day, so you will never be able to get rid of the pixels. But when you make it 100% size, which is something about this size, you cannot see the difference. And another tip, guys, is to try to avoid transforming the same object multiple times. So if you've made it smaller, try not to like rotate it or make it bigger or do anything like that. My tip is to always make backup. So for example, with this banner, if I want to make it smaller or move it to the side, I would always make sure I have a duplicate of that layer. So I would just duplicate it just to make sure I have a backup plan and I can go back if I need to. Now, if you really need to do a lot of resizing and scaling after you've exported your artwork, like if you're preparing it for a client, for example, you might want to switch over to an app like Photoshop and use smart objects. Let's say I want to get that printed or I want to give that to the client, I would share it as a PSD file, which is a Photoshop file, and then I can go into Photoshop and transform each layer into a smart object. And smart objects let you resize your artwork as much as you want without losing quality because they keep the original image data intact. So if you find yourself resizing the same thing over and over again, that might be a better option for you. And that's it, guys. That's how you resize objects in Procreate. Obviously, you cannot make things bigger because it's a pixel app. It's not a vector app. Anything that you do cannot get bigger, but you can make things smaller or you can rotate by using the right interpolation on your transform tool, either bilinear or bicubic, whatever option works best. It's about trying and making sure it works. And also always work with a big canvas so that you have the best quality as possible right from the start, and also avoid resizing the same thing over and over. And if you do need to resize something multiple times, then I would recommend using smart objects. And that's it, guys. That's how you can resize in Procreate without turning your beautiful lines into blurry mess. So let me know in the comments if you have any other questions about Procreate. Always happy to help. And if you're into lettering and book cover design like this example that you can see here, I have an entire online course on how to design book covers, so make sure you check it out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.